Olive production is the cultivation and exploitation of olive trees to make table olives and olive oil. Olive cultivation accounts for 8.6 million hectares in the world. It produces 17.3 million tons of olives each year. The top four producing countries are Spain, Italy, Greece, and Tunisia. They account for 80% of the world production, and 95% of the production is in the Mediterranean basin. The French olive orchard extends over the Mediterranean coast between Nice and Marseille. The olive tree has been present in France since the Pliocene, and the first traces of domestication date back to the Neolithic period and the Mediterranean area. Olive needs heat and little humidity. Provence has a favorable weather, but it's a northern limit of global production. Consequently, the production is less efficient.
Many varieties exist and can be distinguished thanks to their phenotype differences, shape of the tree, leaves, fruits, and their chemical characteristics. There are two types of cultivation, extensive or intensive. Most olive oil is produced with the intensive method, whereas French production is extensive. Even if Provence oil accounts for only 0.22% of global production, it is renowned all over the world. Once the olives are ripe enough, the producers have two picking methods. There is the manual method. The advantage is the possibility to choose the ripeness and the olive size. The other one is the mechanical method, but the taste of olive oil can be altered.
Today, traditional stone mills are not even used. Modern mills have taken their place because of new laws and economic reasons. A strict hygiene is indeed necessary, and the maintenance of stone mills is more difficult. Moreover, this method is less productive than the modern one. There are 9 steps for olive oil production. Olives are placed in the mill and the production process begins. The leaves are separated from the olives and are recovered separately. Olives are cleaned with water to ensure the oil quality. Olives are sorted to keep only the best ones. Then they are ground to extract the oil. The paste is needed to agglomerate oil microparticles and facilitate extraction. Then, the oil is separated from the water and solids thanks to the centrifugation. At the end of the extraction process, the oil is filtered and the final waste is put aside. Now, the oil is ready to be stored in huge vessels.
During this process, waste is generated. One part is solid, this is olive cake. The other is liquid, this is olive water. Olive oil producers can't release waste into the environment without an adapted treatment. It's indeed toxic for the environment because of tannins and other pollutants. The olive sector faces many other issues which decrease production. Frost, drought, bugs, mushrooms like the peacock spot disease, for example, inhibit olive production, but the worst one, without any doubt, is the olive fly. Indeed, the pest is spawned into the olive, causing its fall and makes it unfit for human consumption. All those troubles make this job particularly difficult and incite farmers to abandon their lands.
The financial pressure is indeed very high. They have to buy pesticides, expensive devices like mills, and pay for the treatment of waste. This treatment costs a lot of money. Some producers are not financially able to treat their waste before releasing it into the environment. A solution for the producers of this sector could be waste upcycling. In order to offer economic and environmental solutions, we have decided to create our company OMB, olive Morocco bioresource. As French production is too weak, we have decided to establish it in Morocco. Our aim is to upcycle the olive oil production waste into medicinal mushroom substrate. This type of cultivation is part of a sustainable development approach. Thanks to a free waste recuperation system and an organic mushroom production, OMB, the other companies involved, and the environment, everyone comes out a winner. OMB, smart and green.